and not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
Yes, amen.
You mean that same mind can be in me?
Yes.
You mean I can be transformed by an almighty God, not to continue in my way, but to adopt His way, and that I can leave my family and cleave to His family?
Yes. Come on.
You mean that I
Hallelujah.
Can look to Him as a father and a brother
yes.
and a mother
yes.
and all the friends
yes.
that I need?
Yes.
I would trade them all for the friendship of Christ.
Yes.
You mean, I'm going to tell you something.
You.
Jesus can and does transform
yes.
lives even still today.
Come on.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Listen, 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, the Bible's just full of this. First Corinthians, the second chapter, and the 16th verse. The Bible says in question form, "For who hath known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him?" But we have
come on.
The mind of Christ.
Yeah. Come on.
God is no respecter of persons for sure.
That's right.
But He is a rewarder of those that diligently
yes.
seek Him.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. What does that mean? That if He calls out for you to pray, then pray.
Yes.
If He goes and tells you to wait, then you wait. If He tells you to jump, you say, ha ha.
That's right.
Right.
So we are the body of Christ, and we can have the mind of Christ, but guess what? He's not done yet.
Right.
That's right. Come on. Yes.
Philippians, the first chapter. Were we just there, weren't we? I think it's a pretty easy one, isn't it? Oh, yeah. You mean we can be filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Christ Jesus, unto the glory and praise of God? That sounds like a scripture.
Amen.
Let's look at Ephesians, the 5th chapter. Now, this comes in the middle of great instruction, but it's still very valid. And I think it says, "Be not drunk with wine, where is it in excess, but be ye filled."
Yes. Yes.
With the Spirit? You mean that Spirit? What Spirit? God's Spirit? Whose Spirit? Christ's Spirit? Yes.
Amen.
Be filled with the Spirit. That same Spirit that rose Christ Jesus
yes.
from the dead.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
You mean that Spirit?
Yep.
You mean that Spirit that Joel prophesied about
That's
with Paul?
Right.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You mean that Spirit that the early church enjoyed so much? You mean that Spirit?
Yeah.
Yep.
Come on.
That
yes.
same Spirit.
Amen.
That same Spirit. Amen. That calls you to repentance, and without that you can't be saved?
Right.
Amen.
Right.
You know, if you look at the Scripture literally, it can be very confusing. But it does make literal sense.
That's right. That's right.
Share with you, I don't want to keep mentioning it, but in some of my college classes, I was asked to take a few classes that didn't just go along with pastoring or Christian leadership or the things that I desire. And there were some that I just had to take as electives. Mandatory electives, and one of those, I'm going to tell you, after being out of school for 20 years, Masterpieces of Western Literature 2 was just not at the top of my desire. Well, I expressed my dislike for the subject to the professor. He was like, "Why?" I never liked English too much. I wasn't bad at it. I just never liked it. And one of my first grades came back, and it was a 70-something. And I said, "Ouch." He said, "What, the grade or the comments?" I said, "I never liked the 70s. I was used to getting A's. And I said, I answered the questions, what do you want? More fluff or something? You know, I was just being honest with him, you know. And he said, no, he said, you're trying to convince me that you read the literature. And he said, I take it for granted that you read the literature. I want to know what you think the author was talking about when he was writing the literature.
Uh-oh.
I said, oh. And from that moment, I began to take my pastoral skill of biblical interpretation, because what I want to know most in life is what the author is saying.
Yeah.
when he wrote this word through holy men of God. And I took that skill at biblical interpretation and I applied it to Wuthering Heights. Amen. And Major Barbara. And a few other select pieces of literature that have tiny little writing and many, many pages without many pictures. And by the end of the class, the professor said, great job, most improved student. You're seeing things that English majors don't see. That's because I'm versed in knowing the author, not just the letter.
Amen.
The Bible says the letter killeth, King James, but the Spirit, it gives life. To be filled with the Spirit of Christ then should be our desire,
right?
Our longing, what we hope for, what we need, what we long for, what we hunger for.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Amen. Oh, for a people that would desire that.
Amen.
I'll show you the design of God. One more scripture and I'll be done. Promise. Corinthians, the second chapter, the fourth verse, or the second Corinthians, the fourth chapter, I'm sorry. And this is scripture. It's talking about the treasure that Christ is to humanity. Why God set it up like He set it up, you know, I quiz about. But I've learned to trust Him and by faith move forward. Amen?
Amen.
He says, we have, in the seventh verse, this treasure in earthen vessels. I think we all would kind of look at ourselves as somewhat weak when it comes to God, wouldn't we? But I want to tell you, the design of God is not for you to dwell on what you can do, but rather on what He can do through you. Can you say
amen?
Amen. Let's give the Lord some praise and glory this
morning. Hallelujah.
We have a few folks that need to be baptized. Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And we have a few folks that are going to be joining the church sometime next month. We'll be having some new membership classes.
Amen.
We are going to end up having a couple of different baptisms. One will be this Friday evening. But there are some that can't make it and some family that can't make it. So we'll be having another one to follow shortly thereafter when we can get our schedules arranged. If you need to be baptized, if you've accepted the Lord into your life, come and let me know. I'll be happy to baptize you. And if you desire to be a member of this body, this church, see me, and we'll be having some classes next week. I hope and pray that you will accept the Word of God at its face value. Would you stand with me?